Today, I'm going to show you how to upload a video properly and share it correctly with users. This is a very common requirement for me because I conduct a lot of sessions for customers in person or hybrid, but I prefer to record my own session using my own software. So I send the file to customer. Now you have to upload it and share it. The best place to share is OneDrive. So put it on your OneDrive, create a folder called video and upload it there. You can even drag and drop it from Windows Explorer. Now the next step is to customize and configure it. This is the video. If I click on it, it will start playing. I don't want to play it right now. Hover the mouse, three dots. You'll see a long menu. Choose open in stream. When it opens in a new tab, it will start playing automatically. So first pause it. First thing we want to do is trim it. Why? Because very often we have unwanted areas in the beginning and end. Of course, if I have sent you the video, I will have trimmed it. But here we are talking about any video. So click on the trim button and then you'll see a playhead which is saying video start and same way video end. When you're done, click on commit. So very important thing here, the trim parts are not deleted. The original video is going to remain as it is. But when people are watching, stream is intelligently going to hide those parts. So for all practical purposes for viewers, those parts don't exist. For long sessions, there'll be a break in between. And during that break, the video is still getting recorded and there is nothing happening. So that's why we can add more cuts. So create a new cut, adjust the timing, and you have one more piece removed. The next step is to generate transcript. In order to create the transcript, you go to video settings and choose generate. You have to choose the language. Even if it is English, you choose the correct accent. Now click on generate and it'll take some time. Depending on the duration of the video, if it's 1 hour video, it'll take 1 hour. Now, what is the benefit of this transcript? In a long session, I can read, go to a specific area, click on that part, and it is going to jump to that part. Other thing is searching. So if I search for green, it'll search through it and tell me there are 6 instances of the phrase green tick. I don't have to scroll. I click on this next previous arrows and then this is the one I'm interested in. Click there. It will jump to that specific point. So that's how searching and utilizing the content in the video becomes so much more easy. If it's a really long video, go to video settings and enable chapters. It is capable of generating chapters automatically by looking at the content, analyzing the transcript. The next step is sharing. Click on the share button and you get the familiar standard sharing dialog. It's a good idea to go to this wheel so that you understand what exactly is happening. If you want everyone in the organization to watch the video, then just say people in company, easy, or specific people. And then very important, you don't want others to edit, you want them to view. So give them view permission, apply. And then either send a mail to specific people or copy the link and put it on intranet or chat or wherever you want it. One last step after sharing. Many users may not know that the transcript is searchable. They may not know there are chapters. So when you're sending the link, also send few instructions about how to search the video so that they can utilize the content and learn better and faster. In separate videos, I'll cover 3 more things. You can actually add a quiz right within the video so you can assess how much people have learned. Second, you can edit the video, do titling, combine videos using Clipchamp. And third, you can look at the usage of the video by going to Analytics tab. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.